Hey guys, welcome to today's episode. So in today's episode, I'm going to be solving a problem that I've been getting a lot of feedback from people on how to do something like this and automate something within Excel. And so the example that I have presented today here, and that is, how do you auto-schedule emails based on certain elements within this spreadsheet itself? So for example, in today's scenario, what we're going to do is we're going to automate an email that's going to go one to a sporting goods email address, one to a toys good email address, and another one to a hardware email address. And essentially what this is just product performance information. So there's specific products that are being sold on flyer number one. It tells you about how many units are sold, the gross margin, the revenue, you know, whether the vendor threshold was met, and if it was met, you get a rebate, and if you don't, you don't get a rebate. And what they want to know is, of all these different products, which ones at the end of the day were profitable for this flyer and which ones were not profitable. And sometimes when you're looking at spreadsheets like this, if you're doing flyers every single week, you know, like you would in a retail environment, and you have multiple departments, because in this case, I've only shown three, but you know, normally you'll have 15, 20 plus departments to do, and sifting through this information and auto-scheduling those emails could be a bit of a challenge because there are category executives that want to get information on flyer performance. Now, if you ask me, the best way to do this is I would avoid Excel altogether. And I'm going to link a video up above on how to use something like a graphical API. And my preference is always to go back to the source system and use an API to pull the data and present it in different ways. But I also understand that there's a vast majority of people that still use Excel, which is perfectly fine. And so the question is, rather than manually doing all this stuff, how do you automate some of it? And just a reminder, guys, if you like this kind of content, please subscribe and hit that bell notification icon. So in this scenario, what we're going to do is we're going to build a little script. Now, this Python script that I built over here, although it seems a little involved, it's really quite simple, actually. And we're going to break this script down. But really, the magic happens in these specific lines down here. Everything above here just comes from the actual SendGrid, in this case, Twilio API documentation. And I've made some modifications to it. I've, you know, created a function and I passed some variables to it. The email address that it's coming from is going to be from my email address, which I put in an environment variable. And then finally, we passed, changed a few other things like some of the formatting so that I can actually include the department name as well as the department name in the content as well. And then go ahead and send that file. But we'll go through this in a second. So before I walk through this code, let's go ahead and take a look to see how this actually works. All right, so what I've done here is I've opened up a couple of windows, and in this window, what we're gonna do is we've associated these specific email addresses with the different departments. So this is for sporting, this is for toys, and this is for hardware. So if I go down here, sporting is associated with this email address, this is toys, and this is hardware. And again, I like to use this service quite a bit to do a lot of testing. So essentially what we're gonna be doing here is when I go back to my spreadsheet, what it's gonna be doing is it's gonna take this document, it's gonna send this piece of the information, sporting, to the first email address, it's gonna send toys to the second, and it's gonna send hardware to the third. So let's go ahead and give this a shot. So it's gonna come from an email address, so you can actually put your real email address, but I put test@email.com. And again, I'm using the SendGrid API, which we'll walk through in a second. This snippet of code really just comes from the SendGrid documentation, so there's not a whole lot here. I will walk through some of the changes that I made. But let's see how this works. So now I'm going to go ahead and send this. So when I hit print, basically what it's going to say here now, it's going to say records emailed for sporting. So let's scroll down. Hopefully these start popping in. Some of them have already come in. And it says records sent for toys, 9, records sent for hardware, 10. So basically 10 rows, 9 rows, and 9 rows. And what 202 means is that is this was accepted. So that's a good status code for us to see. So one of the first things you're going to see is one, it's coming from test@email.com. The next thing in the subject line you'll see is it's already broken up by department. So it says monthly sporting, monthly toys, and monthly hardware, which is what we wanted to see. So let's go ahead and open up these emails and see what's in these actual spreadsheets. Now, when you think of the type of use case for this, think about when you actually have to send these kind of reports out to the category executive. So I've worked in retail almost all my life, and I understand the area very well. And there's a lot of category executives, myself included when I was one, who wanted to get this information. Now, like I said, I have a different way of getting data and I go directly to the source and I use APIs, but there's a lot of people who weren't proficient in APIs and still needed to get access to this data, and this was the best way to do it. So let's go ahead and open this up and see exactly what was sent. All right, so let's bring my downloads little file over here so you guys can see it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go up to attachments and we're gonna hit download, and you'll see that it comes downloaded over there. We're gonna do the same thing here, attachments. download, and then finally the last one, attachments, download. Now we're going to open each and every one of these, and what we're hoping to see is we just see the sporting department. And so as you see, that's exactly what we see here. Just make this a little bit bigger. You just see the sporting department details sent over here. It may not be edited or in the right format, but we can always change that later on, even in the code if we wanted to, line by line. Let's look at hardware, which is next. And again, you just see all the hardware details there. And when I look at hardware, there are 10 records, and I believe that's what it said, 10 records for hardware. Probably just validate that very quickly. So hardware had 10 records. And let's go back to the downloads folder. And then finally we had toys. So let's check out toys. And toys had 9 records, and I believe that's what it said that was sent. So 9 records for toys as well. So that's basically what this code does. It's a really cool and handy tool. So if you have people internally that you want to send emails to, or people that are ahead of these reports, you can always certainly do that. So now let's go ahead and double click and walk into the code a little bit more. It's actually not very difficult. The logic is very, very straightforward, very beginner friendly. If you want to learn how to do this, there's really not a whole lot of barriers in terms of trying to understand this. So we'll go through the actual email component in a second, because I said that comes straight from the docs. What we're doing from a development standpoint here is there's a few things. One is, all we've done is we've created a dictionary, and in that dictionary we said, for these specific departments, who do we send this to? Okay, so that's really what this snippet of code means. The df equals pd read underscore excel just basically brings that Excel document and brings it into this environment so that we can actually just go ahead and play with it. So let me show you what that does. We're just going to go ahead and print this here. So we're going to say print df, and I'm going to comment all of this stuff out here because we don't need to send or create any documents at this point. So when I do that, it's just bringing in the entire spreadsheet, and that's all it does. All right, so now let's go ahead and get rid of this and walk through the rest of the code. Again, very, very simple, not too difficult. Here, all we're doing is we're going ahead and printing unique departments. So basically what that means is that I'm getting, if I look at this spreadsheet in Excel here, I'm getting these individual departments out of there, and I want them to be unique. So I just want one instance of sporting, toys, and hardware so that I know what my list looks like. Once we have that list, and we're basically iterating through unique departments. So for for example, in sporting, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and filter out the database so that it's only equal to sporting. We're going to go ahead and call that final underscore, and then because this is I, we're going to call it sporting. The sheet name is going to be called sporting as well. So if I go, for example, into my sheet name here, if I open up this sporting one, my sheet name on the bottom is also called sporting as well. So it's basically going to be the same as the department. And as we move on, we're basically sending an email. So in the email, I'm passing the name of the department, the email address that it needs to go to. So I'm referencing this dictionary using the key, which is whether it's sporting, toys, or hardware. So it's going to go ahead and return the right email address. And then finally, just call it, or the name of the actual file is going to be final underscore sporting in this case, and send it. And that's all we're doing. So once we pass it to this function here, I'm passing in the department only so I can populate the actual title, or the subject in this case, and the HTML header. I'm passing obviously the two email addresses so that I know who it's going to, and then the name of the file. So that's really all I've done here, and that's this component here. I've just added the absolute path is exactly where it's sitting, which directory it's sitting in, and then you just go ahead and append the file, and the file in this case is going to be called one of these three based on the actual loop and where the loop is sitting. And the beauty about this code is I can go ahead and add in something like, let's go ahead and home, and we're going to go ahead and say, I don't know, this is home at email.com. Now it's not going to send anything because home at email.com isn't the email address that we recognize. Maybe it is, or somebody's going to get this email address, but what it is going to do, so I'm going to go back into my spreadsheet here, and we're just going to go ahead and change this last hardware to home so that it knows there's another department. So what it's going to do now, and again, I don't have to go back and edit the code. That's the beauty of the code. I just have to go in and add in a new email address. That's it. So what it does every time, it actually goes ahead and creates these files as well. So we're going to go back to that folder right here. So all we have is our Excel mailer, which is this file, and the actual original spreadsheet. And I'm going to go ahead and hit run on this. And when I hit run, so let's just go ahead and back this out a bit. So when I hit run, it's going to go ahead and create all those individual files. So let's do this right now. So let's go ahead and hit run. And you'll see that It's created hardware, home, sporting, and toys. So you have this for your record as well. So now hardware should have one less record. It stops at 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 6, and that's where it stops. And now when I look at home, it should only have one record. So let's go ahead and take a look at home. And home only has that one record, which is this product. So you can go ahead and change the original data sheet as much as you want. You can add in whatever departments you want, and it'll go ahead and pick it all up, because the way it's coded, it doesn't really matter. It just searches for the unique department name itself. And as long as you go ahead and add in an email address, you're good to go. So that's basically how this code works. It's a really helpful utility. If you don't want to run it through Python and you can't run it through the IDE, the other easy way to really run this is you would go into a terminal window. So let's just open up a terminal window very quickly. And what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and drag this directory into the terminal. So we're going to say CD, and we're going to move that in there. And then you can ls to see what's there. And then really to run this, you can just say Python 3, because that's what I'm running, excelmailer.py. And that's it. You just run it. And of course, I've spelt that wrong, excelemailer.py. And it's going to give you all those records, and it should, in fact, go ahead and send it back to those email addresses. And so let's go ahead and check this out. As you can see, it ran again up there. So like I said, it just works. It's a very, very simple utility. Anybody can use it. You don't even have to have a lot of experience with Python, and you can still use something like this. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that. If you did, please consider liking and subscribing, and I will see you next time. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.